Hello everyone, I am Mehmet Furkan Çolak and I am studying Biomedical Engineering and Mechatronical Engineering at Izmir University of Economic. Now I'm going to talk about PID and my project. Hopefully everyone will understand about PID and you can create such a project like me. Let's look at my project. I know it looks such a mess because of jumpers, but think like that. What does jumper do? Connect two points. So my project has a lot of connection. Generally in universe, every complicated laws are created with very basic rules. If we understand these basic rules, we can use them in order to help humanity or destroy it, like a little boy. Don't worry, even if you are at high school or newly graduated from high school, end of these videos, you will understand 90% of what I talked about. You don't have to know English, I add subtitle. Okay. We should start. Now, I'm summarizing PID. Every machine in the world tries to reach some point. For example, if we arrange the AC 25 Celsius and the current room temperature is 0 Celsius, the AC starts heating to reach desired value, which is 25 Celsius. PID is a method to reach desired value. Instead of desired value, I will say set point. In order to reach set point, systems should have sensors and feedback to know current value. Otherwise, AC could heat even at the room temperature is 44 Celsius. If our system has sensors and feedback, we call it system is closed control system. PID. Proportion, integration, derivation. Proportion means if there is huge differences between current value of sensor and set point, these huge differences, we will call it an error, multiply with some Kp value, such as 1, 2, or 3. And the result is given to motor as a power. It means, if the differences, I mean error, is so much, motor has so much power. If the difference is so small, motor has so small power. You can imagine if the difference is 0.001 and Kp value is 2. Kp times 0.001 is equal to 0.002, which is also power to keep motor working. Is it enough? I don't think so. It isn't enough to keep working. It means we can never reach set point just for using P action. We need I action, integration. By using integration, we don't give power to motor just Kp times differences. Furthermore, we give power to motor Ki multiply with error sum. If we sum the errors periodically, even errors are so small, by time sum of errors will be huge enough to start motor. But sometimes sum of errors is so huge, it may cause overshoot. It means system past the set point value. That is why we need the action. Derivation. Derivation means speed of change of differences. In our system, while it is trying to reach set point, if the speed of change of difference is so high, it decreases power. In the end, there are three values, Kp, Ki, and Kd. We arrange them for maximum efficiency. We don't have to use all of them. Let's look at my project. As you can see, there is LCD screen. By using it, I don't have to use serial print and computer. And there is cute green button. By pushing it, I can arrange set point Kp, Ki, and Kd. And there is DC motor with gearbox. Gearbox create more torque. Behind the DC motor, right here, there is an encoder to calculate current location. My project is about reaching desired location by using DC motor. And there is a motor driver to supply power for DC motor. And where is Arduino? Oh my gosh, there is an Arduino. But don't worry, I used Atmega 328P, which is same chip in Arduino. Nearly every step is same with Arduino. I don't like to use Arduino. It includes so many unnecessary parts for my project. But of course, so many people know Arduino. I will rebuild my project and describe with Arduino and Arduino. This is Arduino. It's programmed with USB to ASP device. It means no Arduino. And this is Arduino, programmed with USB cable. In my Arduino, there is one crystal clock, right here. But in Arduino, there are two crystal clocks. The other one inside the USB to ASP device. I mean, we need just one crystal clock to operate system. Now, let's look how my project works. Now I'm arranging KP values by pushing button. I won't add any I action and I won't add any D action. Our set point is 200, 20, 1. Red line show us the set point value, and green dots are our locations. As you can see, we cannot reach the set point value because we just use P action. And the differences between set point value and our location is steady state error. Let's add some I action. Our set point is 100, 30, 4. As you can see, there is an oscillation. In real system, we don't want to oscillate our system. Now, let's add some B action. I am arranging KP value as the same as the previous one. And also, I am arranging KI value as the same as the previous one. Now, I'm arranging D action. Our set point will be same as the previous one. As you can see, there is a still oscillation. But it will decrease by time. Here is the differences. Without the action, with the action, I mean derivation. The other video, I will show my codes and describe. Thank you for watching me.